I'm Zach. This is my wife, Faith Julian. We are real estate agents here in Knoxville, Tennessee. So I learned about giving pretty much my whole life. My mom and my dad were pretty much staples in that for me growing up. My mom, probably more so than anybody, is the most generous giver I've ever seen.
So I learned about giving as a pastor's daughter. My father was a pastor, and so growing up, giving was just something that I saw was normal. I just remember, you know, they would give me my dollar or my money on Sunday. But obviously I was just a little kid. I wasn't walking in the revelation personally myself. It probably wasn't until about a year or two ago that we really started just digging into scripture, asking the Holy Spirit for a revelation. You know, what does it look like as New Covenant believers to tithe, as opposed to, you know, maybe doing it under the law or just because it was expected. It changed everything when the Lord just started opening our eyes and our heart to the truths behind tithing.
We've always had tough seasons of giving. It hasn't always been, you know, the excitement that we have now. And I met her, and that's when I really got the revelation of how God first loved me and all that. So my relationship really built in. And then, you know, you start plugging in and you start learning about the tithe and getting that revelation. And I didn't have it then. So I can remember I was like, well, crap, my bank account's not really there. I was like, I really need that little 10% there so I can keep building, because I just married my wife and I wanted her to feel secure.
And it is interesting because we made less then, but yet it was harder. And we really did struggle with it. And even my language back then was, but we have to tithe. Not out of joy, it was just, but we need to. This is what we're supposed to do. But it wasn't necessarily joyful. It just wasn't at that time.
Yeah.
Until we got that revelation. A verse that stood out to me was in Malachi, and it's a well-known verse, but it's the only time in the Bible that God says, try me in this. Test me in this, and he's talking about the tithe. And he talks about, will I not open up the doors of heaven and will not flood you with blessings so much that you can't receive it and contain it? I believe revelation's walked out, and so it's not always easy, and your mind will sometimes play games with you, but if you walk it out, you're gonna see his faithfulness, you're gonna see his goodness, you're gonna see him come through, just like Malachi 3 says, and he'll always outgive you. He just will.
And we've talked about this too, so that's key, walking it out for us too. But one thing that I think changed everything along with that for us was our mouth. So don't only just walk it, but talk it. Life and death is in the power of the tongue, so we try and watch everything we say. So we're in a crazy season right now with everything going on in the world. Like, you don't know what's gonna happen. It's all about what you speak and say too, because that's gonna come to pass. So that's huge for us.
So what I would say to somebody who's never given before is take a step of faith. It never feels good to hold on to something. And I truly feel that when you take a step of faith, wherever you are, and whatever that looks like for you, you're gonna experience a whole wave of freedom in that area of your life. Because it is the devil's plan to keep us bound, to keep our finances bound, to keep us worried and insecure, and especially during this time. I know that if you step out in faith and you trust him as a good father, that you are gonna be so happy you did, because freedom, there's no price tag on it. And it's not about the size of your gift to God. He loves you and you're qualified because of what Jesus has done, and you are blessed. You're a new covenant child. So the tithe doesn't make you more loved. I just feel like those open hands will allow you to experience more of his love, more of his freedom, because you're open. You're not clenched.
We are the Julians, and we give because God's been so good and so faithful to us.